Southern African Connection, and we are here today covering the Tanzania Union Day open house. And this is the day where the Tanzanian community celebrates the union between Zanzibar and Tanganyika when they became a union of Tanzania. And so we have cultural events, we have cabinet members from the Tanzanian government, we have the ambassador, Madam Mulamula, and we have the Tanzanian business community. They have booths set up where we see the different businesses that they are in, the products that they are selling, and we also have plenty of food, plenty of dance, and plenty of cultural activities. So this is an awesome event for Southern Africans to know about Tanzania and the history of Tanzania. So we will take a spin, look around, see what the various things that we have, and we'll be right back to you. Tanzania and Zanzibar united as one country from Tanganyika and Zanzibar to Tanzania. Sorry, this was way back when. So here with me today is a fellow Tanzanian, someone from our community, and his name is Safari, and I will not butcher his last name. I'll have him give us his last name.
Okay. Last name is Umwe. Thank you very much. Perhaps just by way of introduction, I am a veteran of Washington.
Okay.
I've been here many years. Uh-huh. So I am familiar with many small African communities and communities from other parts of the world.
Right.
And one of the things that we learn about being in America is sticking together as a community. You begin to take the benefits of this free country. This country is free for those who can take advantage of the available environment. Political environment, social environment, resources are here, and you can expand your knowledge. And I came here to the United States many, many years back.
Right.
But it's enough to say that I've been here more than 30 years.
All right. And so what does being a Tanzanian who's lived here for so many years and you still are connected with Tanzania, what does this day mean for you as a Tanzanian?
As a Tanzanian, first, one thing. This day is a union day, a dream that was started by our founders of the free continent of Africa. I'm talking about Julius Nyerere and Karume of the islands of Zanzibar. this whole idea of Africans coming together had been in the minds of our leaders during the independence struggles. And the islands of Zanzibar and Tanganyika are closed. So we, according to our founders, they thought that if we really want Africa to be united, like the United States, it begins at home. If we can do it, first we're neighbors, if we can do it, then we can build on that and expand to become the United States of Africa. Of course, as you know, that dream hasn't come true yet.
Right, it's still a dream in progress.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
Similarly, the union of Tanganyika and Zanzibar to form Tanzania is what we hear.
That's why we are here today, 50 years celebration, way back in April 1964.
Okay.
We were
That's born. A long time. No, we were not born yet.
Exactly. But I was there.
That is great. So, being a Tanzanian, living in Washington, D.C. for so many years, and still connected with the country, what is your aspirations for Tanzania and for Tanzanians here in America?
Yes, my legacy is this. Having lived so many years in this country, I have looked at the African continent. I know America very well, just almost as much as I know Africa. But there is one thing that unites people, one of the key elements that unites people, is the language. Language is part of your culture, part of your tradition.
Right.
When you look at the African continent today, we are not fortunate to have an African
language. Right.
And it's not our fault, it's not anybody's fault. It has happened in many other parts of the world. The way it happened is some big ruler runs over the smaller ones and decides which language is going to be.
Right.
But all African countries decided that's not the way to go. If there is a language that's going to evolve, let it evolve from the culture of the people. We in East Africa have been very fortunate to have Swahili that doesn't belong to any tribe.
Yeah, it's a fusion.
It's a trading language that evolves
over
on
time.
The Indian Ocean trade.
Mm-hmm.
And it became a language of trade. And then, of course, Tanzania was smart enough to adopt it as
a national
language. And so today, my legacy would be to expand that legacy of Africa's one language. And Swahili has the potential of being the language. And that's why I wrote this book.
connection, and I'm here today at the Tanzania Union open house, and I'm speaking with
Lillian Daniele.
And Lillian is from Tanzania, and as a Tanzanian, what does this day mean to you?
This day means a lot to us because it's 50-year independence, and we're so happy to be here today. Without the independence, I don't know where we could have been, but we're just so happy to be here to celebrate this day with you from another country and everybody else here.
Absolutely. So for us Southern Africans, this is a union of Tanganyika and Zanzibar to form Tanzania. And similarly, all of us, Tanzanians, Zimbabweans, how wherever we are from, we form a union to be Southern Africans. And so I see you are exhibiting some stuff here. And how does this bring together you as a Tanzanian American and the culture? How do you keep us connected with our culture through what you do here?
Thank you. As you can see, we have everything for you. This is all African prints, as you can tell. But you know, we are bringing it into a new life. You know, we're in America, and African prints. Couldn't see this like a few years back, but now everybody's just loving African prints, and
so it's a fusion of American style with African print, and when we wear it as Southern Africans or Africans in general, we identify with each other. We know, oh, it's our fellow brother or fellow sister. So thank you so much. It was nice talking to you.
For keeping ourselves together, staying peaceful, not having civil wars.
Right.
So this day is for us celebrating our oneness, our togetherness.
Togetherness.
Different religions, different cultures, different ethnic tribes, all in one country. Mm-hmm. We have about, not even known, but over 120 tribes
oh, wow.
in
that's
Tanzania
a,
alone.
That's a lot. So this is a really great achievement to unite all those people, all those different ethnicities, tribes, and using one language, Swahili, as Tanzanian. So we are really proud and we are happy to be here celebrating with the Tanzanians. Thank you so much for talking to us.
You visited us and you're welcome to come again. We hope to have this year.
We will always be here. We are at the end of the day. This has been an exciting day here at the Tanzanian Union Day Open House. A union day that celebrates the union of Tanzania and of Tanganyika and Zanzibar to form Tanzania. This was way back in 1964. We had a great day, we had music, we had cultural shows, we had dramas, great food, and also fashion shows. So all in all, it was a great day. I hope our viewers, you enjoy this. So this is from me, Omega Tawonezvi, for Southern African Connection. Have a good day.